Dear learners, I am Dr. Vinay Supe. Today, we will discuss the topic on flowering, bahar management, harvesting, grading and packaging of pomegranate. Let us discuss flowering and fruiting in pomegranate first. Pomegranate flower throughout the year, hence it has scattered fruiting. Therefore, plants needs to be forced to rest period to enable fruit harvest at a given time. The flowers of the spring flush are born on the mature wood, that is 1 year old wood. The flowers during July-August are born on the current season's growth. There are two types of flowers in pomegranate. This is very important. One is male and another is hermaphrodite. The hermaphrodite flowers contains both the sexes, that is male and female sexes. However, in male flowers, the female part is rudimentary and only the male part is functional. The flowers are found mostly in clusters, either terminally or in axils of the leaves. In India, there are three flowering seasons, that is Ambia Bahar, Mruga Bahar and Hasta Bahar. But we can modify those bahars. We can take early Ambia or late Ambia, likewise early Mruga, late Mruga, early Hasta, late Hasta. It depends on the climatic conditions and we can have throughout the year flowering. If you think of only Ambia Bahar, the bahar, it starts during January, February and it ends in July and August. However, in case of Mruga Bahar, the Mruga Bahar starts in June, July and the harvesting is in December. In case of Hasta Bahar, the bahar starts during September, October and the fruits mature during March, April. That's why we have to harvest the fruits in March, April. Any bahar, that is Ambia Bahar, Mruga Bahar or Hasta Bahar, the bahar treatment, it is very much essential for the pomegranate crop, being a xerophyte. Pomegranate plant may be induced to bear fruit in any of the season. It is forced to produce flower and fruits in particular season by adopting certain techniques. It is artificial stress creation with no supply of water and nutrition. Now let us know about bahar treatment. We have seen already the importance of the bahar and now we will see how we are going to give the bahar treatment. Bahar treatment is done to accumulate carbohydrates in the plant body for better fruit bud differentiation. If you want to have more flowers and more fruits, then bahar treatment is a must. For this, application of nutrients after harvesting and irrigation up to 30 days is must before resting stage. After that, the irrigation should be stopped. The period of withholding of water depends on the soil type. If the soils are light in nature, the stress of 30 days would be sufficient. However, in case of medium soils, it may extend to 40 or 45 days. While in case of heavy soils, it requires stress of 60 days or even more. So, it depends on the soil type, even the climate also. If you are going to have stress during summer season, this period may be somewhat earlier than the recommended period. In this case, actually, the root exposure to the sunlight by digging the soil is one of the important operation of bahar treatment. This is most important to control the nematodes also in the soil. So that is very essential. Root exposure or root pruning should be done 15 days before start of the new bahar. After getting proper stress to the pomegranate plant, plant metabolism is slowed down. Leaves become yellow and fall off, or the leaf shedding, it starts from this particular stage. This leads to more carbohydrate storage in the branches. During resting period, plowing, harrowing, pruning of dead wood, etc., all these operations we have to perform. Now we will see how the Mruga Bahar is taken. Mruga Bahar coincides with the break of monsoon. This bahar is practiced in water scarcity area only, particularly where the scarcity of water is there. In this particular area, we prefer this mruga bahar. In this particular bahar, watering is withheld from April, May to June. So that is the period of withholding of water. The stress of 1 to 2 months results in growth suppression and shedding of leaves. After getting 30% of natural leaf fall, light pruning is done. Manures and fertilizers are applied, and then light irrigation at weekly intervals are given. Initially, we have to give light irrigations, and then as per the recommended dose of irrigation, we have to irrigate those plants. Within a fortnight, plants will produce profuse growth subsequently, leading to flower and fruit formation. Harvesting starts in the month of December in this particular bahar. In this bahar, more incidence of pest and diseases occur as the fruiting coincides with the onset of monsoon. In this particular period, the climate is mostly humid because of the rains. That's why the disease incidence is comparatively more. Hence, the cost of production is higher in this particular bahar as compared to other bahars. Now we will see how the ambia bahar can be taken. The ambia bahar starts in the month of January and the fruits are harvested during July, August. The total flowering as well as the fruit growth, it comes in the summer season. Hence, enough water availability should be there for taking ambia bahar. If you have irrigation water available, then and then you can go for ambia bahar. Watering is withheld from October onwards, about for 2 months. Plants shed their leaves in December end or the January start. After getting 30% of natural leaf fall, light pruning is done. That is recommended. We are not recommending the heavy pruning. We are only recommending light pruning. So after that, manuring and fertilizer are applied, and then light irrigation is given. Flowers appear 30 days after start of irrigation. The fruiting coincides with the hot and dry summer. Hence, fruits should be protected from sun scorching, covering the fruits with paper or synthetic bags. Nowadays, the synthetic bags are available in the market. Those bags also we can use. Or otherwise, a synthetic cloth, it is also available in the market. That cloth can be used as a protection for this sun scorching. The insect and disease attack is minimum as compared to other bahars in this particular bahar because of the dry climate. In this particular climate, from January to June, there is hot summer. That's why the climate remains the dry, and that's why the incidence of disease and insect pest is comparatively low. Fruits are harvested in June, July, or up to the end of August. Ambia bahar is best bahar for quality yield as compared to rest of the bahar. If you compare mruga bahar, hasta bahar and ambia bahar, the fruits of ambia bahar are comparatively better in quality than rest of the bahar. Now we will see the hasta bahar. It starts from September to October and the plants remain under dormancy during August-September. In hasta bahar, due to rainy season, it is not possible to withhold water. In such situation, defoliation can be done by spraying ethereal, that is artificial defoliation we have to do. And in this particular case, we use ethereal, spray of ethereal at a concentration of 2 ml per liter of water. Fruits mature in March-April. The fruits maturity comes in the hot and dry climate, hence the fruits doesn't get proper color. That's why the market acceptance for this particular bahar is comparatively less. Hasta bahar is the most advisable for arid and semi-arid regions with limited resources. But in particularly if you see the pest and disease incidence in case of hasta bahar, it is comparatively low than mruga bahar and ambia bahar also. Now let us see the maturity of pomegranate fruit. The maturity indices are also important to have a proper harvesting. The maturity period varies according to the variety. In popular varieties like Bhagwa, Bhagwa Super, the fruits become ready for harvest in about 180 to 200 days after fruit set. In other varieties like Mrudula, Ganesh, Arakta, this period varies from 135 to 150 days. At the maturity, fruit color changes to blood red, from the green to blood red. There is separation of fruits on each side. At maturity, if the fruits are pressed, distinct crisp sound of eril cracking will be observed. Closing of calyx at distal end of the fruit, that is also the important maturity sign. Likewise, total soluble solids. If you take refractometer in the field and if you analyze the fruit itself in the field, if the TSS of the fruit is more than 16% or 16 degree bricks, then that is also one of the important sign of maturity. Now we will see how the harvesting should be done. The fruits are harvested when the skin turns blood red. Fruit produced a metallic sound when tapped. Harvesting should be done at full physiological maturity, as I have explained earlier. Harvesting should be done early in the morning to get the benefit of the cool climate. Harvesting is usually done by cutting the pedicel of the fruit with the help of secateur, or even we can do hand plucking also. Discard the affected fruits. Keep the quality fruits in plastic crates. Collect the fruits in crates and transport them in the packaging shed. A well-developed 5 to 8 years old tree can give 150 to 200 fruits per season, or per year we can say, because we are taking only one season. The total yield per tree ranges between 25 to 35 kg. Now, all those harvested fruits, we have to grade according to various grades. So, grading is very much essential for better marketing. The fruits should be graded as per the size, shape, fruit color, and fruit weight. The fruits should be marked as an A grade. A grade fruits means more than 400 gram weight. The fruits ranges between 300 to 400 grams, it comes under B grade. And the fruits which ranges between 250 to 300 grams, it comes under C grade. So, likewise, grade wise, we have to grade all those fruits. Discard small, injured and cracked fruits. Packaging also is important for distant market or for export markets. Generally, corrugated fiber boxes of various sizes for 6 fruits, 12 fruits, etc. are used for packaging. Even for the local or the nearby markets, we can package all those fruits in the plastic crates also. After packaging, the storage of pomegranate fruits is done at ordinary room temperature. Fruits can be stored in cold storage at 7 degree centigrade and 90% relative humidity for more than 8 weeks. To summarize this topic of bahar treatment, flowering, then harvesting, grading and packaging, to produce or to harvest the quality A grade fruits of pomegranate, proper bahar treatment is very essential. Likewise, to market those fruits in indigenous as well as in the export markets, proper harvesting, grading and packaging is also important. I hope you understood this topic properly. Thank you.